So today we want to wish all good morning and everybody as well. I'd like to today's message to be about thank you. You know, we say can you put it in the slideshow real quick?
Proper thanks means proper something. What do you think that something is? It's a long word,
starts with the letter A. And it's not anti-disestablishmentarianism, it's something else. Yeah. Shorter than that.
No.
Who said that?
Who said that?
You're right. Acknowledgement.
Acknowledgement.
To acknowledge something, to realize it happened, to recognize the one who made it happen. Giving the glory to God, in other words. Proper thanks to the Lord needs proper acknowledgement. If we're not going to acknowledge Him in everything, then we're not able to properly thank Him. Because this is a fact. If we search carefully enough, if we look deep enough and carefully enough, you'll notice that anything good in your life is thanks to God. Nobody else, not even you. Because He's the creator of it all. So it all started with Him. So what about the bad that happens? The bad is permitted by His mercy. By His mercy. Or by His good will for us all. Sometimes we need to go through tough things to get to the good things. As St. Paul says, all things work together for the good to those who love God. Sure, you've heard, a lot of you have heard this song, Blessing by Laura Sprint. Anybody hear this song before? I think it was written in 2011. This is just a part of the song. It's the refrain, the chorus. It says, because if your blessings come through raindrops, so she's telling you, if your blessings come through raindrops, what if your healing comes through tears? What if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes to know you are near, know that God is near? What if trials of this life are actually your mercies in disguise? So you think, oh, that sounds like, you shouldn't hear the song, I already going to like it. It's a very nice song, the words are very meaningful. Her name is Laura Story, I think she wrote it in 2011. Blessing, it's called. You think, well, it's a song, she's a songwriter, she's an artist, it's easy to put words on paper. Yeah, that's true, well, to a certain extent. But let me tell you something about her. Her husband, shortly after their marriage, was diagnosed with a brain tumor and had to go through multiple surgeries. So she didn't exactly have it easy in her life. And she didn't write this before her husband got sick. She wrote it after. Which means that she realized, to count her blessings and thank God, that it was good that they found this tumor early, for example, in her husband's head, before it was too late. The idea is we need to train. It takes training. We are not good at exercising ourselves in being positive or thankful to the Lord. We're not very good at it as human nature. So it's a good song, and these words I think are arranging in the note, strike a chord. Some of you may have seen this, probably saw this in emails before you. If you can't read it too well, I'll read it for you. It says, if you have food in your fridge, clothes on your back, a roof over your head, and a place to sleep, you are richer than 75% of the world. 75% of the world, imagine. Then it says, if you have money in the bank, your wallet, and some spare change, you're among the top 8% of the world's wealthy. 8%, imagine. It says, if you woke up this morning with more health and illness, then you are more blessed than the million people who will not survive this week. If you've never experienced the danger of battle, the agony of imprisonment or torture, or the horrible pangs of starvation, you are luckier than 500 million people, alive and suffering. And if you can read this message, you are more fortunate than 3 billion people in the world who can't read at all. I think it gives us, kind of changes our perspective on a lot of stuff. Imagine, this is the first one. We're richer than 75% of this planet. That's a lot of people. But for some reason, we can't see these percentages when we're going to work Monday morning. Or on our way back, when we get our apartment, or our hydro, or when the kids are failing their June exam. We can't see any of that. All we see is the 25% that we want to put ourselves in. Or the other 92% that don't have whatever in their wallet. For some reason, we flip the book and we think we can, you know, give ourselves, we are entitled to put ourselves in that category. Sounds pretty sad to me, I don't know. It's strange. I think we need to put these numbers in front. Right, personally, I think I'm going to put it on my dashboard tomorrow. Right, where this kilometer passes 60 kilometers an hour. When you're about to speed because the guy in front of you is driving too slow, you see this percentage and you think, wait a minute. Maybe he has a serious problem that he has to get. He doesn't have to be a reckless driver. It's good to give the benefit of that to the times. But I really think it's important for us to remember these numbers as a basic reference point to realize how really blessed we are. Have you ever heard of this boy? Raise your hand if you've heard of him. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I know that 7. It's mostly women, so you all Oprah fans, weren't you? You all watched Oprah Winfrey. Yeah, Maddie Stefani was a guest on the Oprah Winfrey show many, many, many years ago.
So these are examples of people
people who understood what it means to acknowledge God and thank Him for all. Kind of like when Job lost everything, he said, "The Lord has given, the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord." Blessing, counting thanks, counting blessings, being thankful to God. So I have some quotes from Matty that I find nice that might inspire you this week. He said, "Keep all special thoughts and memories for our lifetimes to come. Share these keepsakes with others to inspire hope and hope for the past, which can bridge to the future." Very simple, but very profound. We need to remind ourselves to do that, you know. Remember the good times. Don't just think, oh, they're good times back then. Let's share them. Let's inspire each other. We can do this. We can do this again. We can make it happen. We can have a positive effect on the society we live in. We can actually be Christians for once, just by remembering the good. We think of the people that preceded us to heaven. Now St. Paul says, remember those who preceded us. Remembering, looking at the outcome of their conduct. We have people that have led the way, followed Christ faithfully. They inspire us. That's why we read the Synaxarian after the reading of the book of Acts. We read the biography of the saint of the day, of the saints of the day, so we can get inspired. Hey, if they did it, we can also do it. We don't have to walk around as saints and do miracles. That's not what God wants. He just wants us to love. He wants us to be Christian. He wants us to give. When He told the apostles yesterday night in the gospel and this morning, when they said, "You know what, Jesus? It's getting late. Send these people away. Let them go into town and get some food. We don't have food for them." Jesus said, "No. You give them. You give them something.
Praiseworthy.
your brain and your brain cells meditating on things that are negative and profane and useless and material and temporary and temporal. Meditate on the Lord's love for you and how much He cares about you and how much He's done all this for you and how He redeemed you by His precious blood. Meditate on these things. Let's learn from a boy like Maddie. I consider Maddie a role model for me personally. I wish I could be like Maddie today. Very good example of a person who is thankful to the Lord in all things and acknowledging the Lord. And like we said earlier, a little thank you goes a long way. It says there is no gift that does not increase except the gift that is not thankful. The more you thank God, there's a story about this man who kept on complaining. God's giving him nothing. And there's another man who kept thanking the Lord for everything, from the breath he breathes to everything. So he kept getting more. So the man that was thankful realized that this man didn't have as much. He felt bad for him, so he prayed. He said, "Lord, would you mind, please? You give me way too much. Could you give what you give me to him, or some of what you've given me to this person?" He told him, "I'd love to, but he's not thankful for anything." You see, it's very simple. You're so thankful, so the equation is you thank, I give. You thank, I give. So you're almost thankful, so I'm giving you. He doesn't thank anything for anything. So how can I give him? He doesn't thank for anything. Very simple. We think thanking God is only on Thanksgiving, a piece of turkey. No, I'm sorry. Thanksgiving is every day of the week, every hour of the day. It said here, I just skipped it, but it said stop global whining. I laughed when I saw that. You know how people stop global warming? This one said stop global whining. I think there's a big problem with the world. Did you go back to the forest? Stop global whining. I mean, people are great whiners. Whine about everything. Just no thankfulness and nothing. Let's not worry about global warming. I don't think we have a big problem with global warming today. But we do have a big problem with global whining. Let's try. Be thankful. Remember Maddie this week. Glory be to God forever and ever.